212 Kids. I am so excited to talk to you guys today. And let me just tell you, we're in a brand new month, and things around here are getting a little bit sticky, right? Now, all this month, we're going to talk about, oh, I need some more. We're going to talk about how things can get stuck. And haven't all of us felt stuck before? Like maybe your bike got stuck in the mud, or your finger got stuck to some tape, or you got stuck with a question on a test, or maybe something got stuck to your nose. But whatever the case may be, here is the good news. We can get unstuck with a little determination. And here's what we're calling determination, guys. It's deciding that it's worth finishing what you started. Well, we have an incredible, true Bible story for you today. But first, let's have some praise and worship.
Everyone is part of a bigger story. It's a bigger story than you can imagine. It's a big story about a really big God. Discover the story that shows you the character of God.
Hey, I'm Caleb, and this right here is one epic library. The Bible is a series of books that fit together to tell God's one big story. He inspired dozens of people over hundreds of years to write down his words in the form of adventures, of history, letters, words of wisdom, and even poetry. In the Bible, we discover people who face some incredibly difficult jobs, but chose to keep going and follow through. They displayed amazing determination. And I've got five stories to show you what it can look like. We get started in the book of Matthew. Here, Jesus has returned to life, and his friends are filled with joy. Then, Jesus gives them a giant job to do. But with Jesus walking beside them, they can do anything, right? But God's plan leaves all their expectations a little up in the air. Next, we jump forward a few weeks in time to the book of Acts. Jesus has returned to heaven, but he's promised his friends some amazing help from God. Sounds great, except they don't quite understand what this help is going to be like. Then one day, they're all gathered together when the sound of a strong wind fills the room and flickers a flame appear above their heads. And all they can think is, we didn't start the fire. Sliding along into Acts chapter 3, we discover two of Jesus's friends, Peter and John, heading to the temple. On the way, a man who can't walk asks for help, and they heal him through Jesus's power. That's amazing, right? Except the religious leaders don't think so. In fact, they're so threatened by Jesus's friends, they do their best to keep Peter and John from walking out of there. Now, we pick up speed in Acts 6. And meet up with a man named Stephen. He's so filled with God's love and power that the religious leaders decide to shut him down for good. Instead of backing off though, Stephen stands tall and speaks truth, because he already knows how the story ends. We wrap up the month in Acts 8. Here, we find another Jesus follower, Philip, who refuses to stop sharing about Jesus. See a trend here yet? So when God's Spirit sends him out into the desert, Philip's gotta be thinking, what is up with that? What's up is a royal official from Ethiopia on a road trip. Someone with a question even bigger than Philip's. Jesus had gone to be with God, but he didn't leave his followers alone. Instead, his friends relied on the incredible power of God's Spirit to keep sharing the true story of Jesus, no matter what it cost. That took true determination. And I can't wait to see how it plays out in you and me.
Man, isn't that amazing? All that cool stuff that we're going to talk about. Well, today we're going to pick up in God's big story after Jesus has already died on the cross and then come back to life. And we're talking about his disciples. And with his disciples, they were his best friends. And they had seen Jesus do some amazing things at the time that they had followed him. They saw Jesus perform all these crazy miracles that we've talked about before at 212 Kids. Like when he would pray for people that were blind and their eyes would pop open. Or the time that he prayed for Lazarus who had died and the dude came back to life. It was amazing. They had seen Jesus teach hundreds and hundreds of people that would gather around to hear all of his teaching. And some of them had actually heard the voice of God say about Jesus that this is my son who I love. Well, the disciples had also experienced and seen some really sad things that they had gone through with Jesus. They had seen one of their best friends, Judas, who had betrayed Jesus, that turned him over to the religious leaders. They had seen Jesus get arrested. They'd seen Jesus put on trial. They saw Jesus and experienced him get nailed to a cross and buried in a tomb. And that obviously was the saddest day of all. And the disciples, they probably thought, that's it. It's over. The story has ended. But there was still more to the story. We talked about that, how Jesus did the impossible and he rose from the dead and came back to life. And the disciples, they were there to experience this amazing miracle, the greatest miracle of all time. Well, then in the book of Matthew, as we're going to talk about today, Jesus told his disciples, I want you to go to the Mount in Galilee. And the disciples didn't know exactly why Jesus wanted them to go there, but he said, go there and then I'll show you what's going to happen. Well, they trusted Jesus, so they went anyway. And all of a sudden, Jesus showed up on the mountain. Here's what it says. It says that when they saw him, they worshiped him. But some of them still had their doubts. Now, I don't know how they could still doubt because Jesus had died and now he's alive, but they still doubted. And some of them thought, this seems too good to be true, that Jesus actually is alive. But here's what Jesus says. He says in Matthew 28, verse 18, he told his disciples, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. See, here's the thing. Jesus wanted to remind his disciples that he was the Son of God, that nothing was impossible for him. But it didn't stop there. Jesus says, hey, I have a new job for you guys. I have a new thing that I want you to do. And here's what it is, guys. You are going to be teachers. They're like, what teachers? What are you talking about? Jesus says, here's what I want you to teach. I want you to teach everyone everything about me. Jesus said this to them. He said in Matthew 28, so you must go and make disciples of all nations. Baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit and teach them to obey everything I have commanded you. And I will be with you to the end. Now, let me tell you something. Teach everyone everything. That is a huge job. They're supposed to go to every nation and tell everybody about Jesus. That's impossible. How would they tell the whole world about Jesus? That's what they must have thought, that this is going to be impossible, that how are we going to do this? Well, Jesus and his followers returned to Jerusalem, and one day he led them to a hill outside the city. And the Bible says that Jesus was sitting and having a meal with his disciples. Now you think, why would the Bible talk about Jesus eating food? Well, it proved that Jesus actually was alive, that he had come back because he was actually eating food just like you and me. They weren't dreaming. He was living. He was breathing. And now he was eating. Well, Jesus told his disciples, man, get ready because I'm going to do something for you very soon that's going to be amazing. I'm going to give you a gift, an amazing gift that's going to help you accomplish the job that I have for you to teach everyone about me. Here's what he says in Acts chapter 1 in our Bibles. It says this, Jesus says, do not leave Jerusalem. Wait for the gift that my Father has promised. You've heard me talk about it. John baptized with water, John the Baptist baptized with water, but in a few days, you'll be baptized with the Holy Spirit. He went on to say this, and this is the amazing part. He says, when the Holy Spirit comes on you, you're going to receive power. Then you'll be able to tell people in Jerusalem, in Judea, and in Samaria, and you'll even tell other people about me on the other end of the earth. Well, after he told them about this, it was the amazing thing is that Jesus went up into heaven. He ascended into heaven, and the disciples are watching him. He's going up in the air, and they just keep watching until they can't see Jesus anymore. Well, suddenly, two men dressed in white showed up. And I'm sure you can guess, these two men, they were angels. And they asked the disciples, dudes, I don't know if they said dudes, but they said, dudes, why are you standing here looking up in the sky watching for Jesus? There are people that need to hear about Jesus. It's time to get started. Well, Jesus had given his followers what seemed to be this impossibly huge job, that they were to share the story of Jesus with every nation around the world. And they had no idea how they were going to do it, but they remembered that Jesus said, hey, I'm going to give you a gift. I'm going to promise you something that's going to help you. So they remembered Jesus said to go wait in Jerusalem, and that's exactly what they did. They waited for the gift of the Holy Spirit. They trusted God was going to come through with the promise that he had given them. Just like you and I can trust every promise that's in the Bible, we can trust it to be true because that's the kind of God that we serve. Well, here's the really cool part, okay? Jesus has given you and given me the same mission. Our job is to tell everyone about Jesus. He wants us to tell everyone that Jesus loves them, that Jesus wants to save them, that Jesus wants them to go to heaven. We are part of God's big story. God wants us to continue the work that his disciples started. And I know this seems impossible, but we have our bottom line for you today, and it's this, that we can keep going even when it seems impossible. Because God promised that he'll be there for us just like he was there for his disciples. So let's thank God and let's pray and ask him to help us to share the great news about Jesus. God, we thank you for your word again. God, we thank you that you're such a good God, that you're such a faithful God, that you're such a true God, a God that loves us and cares about us. And God, we thank you for this gift that you've given us, the Holy Spirit, to help us to continue the work that you've given the disciples. That God, what a big job it is to tell everyone about you. But God, we don't have to do it on our own. You're there for us to help us. And we thank you for that, Lord, in Jesus' name. You know, from the beginning, God had a plan to rescue us. Adam and Eve sinned. They messed up. They did something their own way. They rebelled against God's way. And from that point on, God had a plan to redeem us to him. That's why he sent Jesus. Jesus came and died on the cross to save us from our sins so that we could be forgiven, so that on the third day when he rose again, he could give us the same mission that he gave his disciples, that, hey, we need to tell the world about Jesus. And it must have seemed impossible for the disciples to carry out this mission, but God made them a promise. Jesus made them a promise that he'd always be with them. And just like with the disciples, Jesus is with us. We can have determination to know that we can get unstuck in the challenges that we face. No matter what we face, God is going to be with us. Jesus is going to be with us. We can remember, even though we're going through what we're dealing with right now, with this virus and being quarantined and being at home, we can remember that Jesus is going to be with us, and we can keep going even when it seems impossible. When we feel like we're stuck, we can remember God is with us. We can trust that no matter what, that God's going to be with us to help us to get unstuck, that we can continue and choose to live every day for him. You know what? Let's take a look at our memory verse today for this month. It's found in Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. And here's what it says. Let's not become tired of doing good. At the right time, we'll gather a crop if we don't give up. That's what determination is, not giving up. And God wants us to realize that he is with us to help us and be determined to make good things happen, even when it seems impossible. Well, I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed our time together this week. I'm praying for you. I miss you so much. Have a great week.